I've been to our local Rona, and I picked up a type of lumber that I have never bought before, never used it before. And if you come on over a little closer, I'll show you what I got here. Now at first glance, this looks like it's all one beautiful board. But when you look close, you can see that it's actually made up of strips. They're probably about 2 inches wide or so, and they're glued together. And I've never used this before. It looks really nice. It's done so well, it almost looks like it's just one board. And it's nice and flat. It's not cupped or crowned or anything like that. Nice and straight. And it says that it's lightly sanded. Now there's only one thing that I really don't like about this is it sort of makes me feel like some sort of a workshop sissy when I use stuff like this, because it makes it almost too easy. Wonder what they're trying to hide under this great big label. Aha! Just kidding. Well, they did pretty good. They didn't hide anything under the labels. Now, as you can see here, it's not a full 3/4 of an inch thick like a normal board. But they didn't try to hide that either. Because when I bought it, I could clearly see that it was only 11/16 of an inch thick. 12/16 is a normal board. Now I just tried out my dado blades the way they were set up from before, and I guess obviously I was doing something that was 3/4 of an inch thick. And I was planning on using my table saw anyway, not the radial arm saw, so shouldn't be too hard to reset everything. Well, I've rearranged the shims and the chippers. I don't know if you can see that or not, but we've got exactly 11/16 there. Of course, it's going to be a little bit wider once it's on the table saw, because there will be a little bit of wobble. Well, thank goodness for time lapse. Whoops, I got this one on backwards. Now I should really be wearing my gloves for this. Now if I can, I like to draw out on the computer first what it is that I'm going to make. And in this case I drew out the plan. And this is going to be a little cupboard for little items that I don't want to get dust on them. It'll have two little doors in the front. It'll be sort of a miniature cupboard that you would have in your kitchen. Well, you'll see as we go along here. Got a piece of scrap here. Going to use it as a test piece. And just see if we got the width pretty close. And I'm going to turn on all the dust collection equipment I can muster here, because I know it's going to be throwing it out here. Well, that's pretty good. I sure wouldn't want it any tighter though. It's actually a perfect fit. Now these boards are exactly 48 inches long. And they've been cut nice and square already in the factory. So don't need to worry about that. But the case that I'm going to make, it has to be 47 15/16 of an inch from here to here. Otherwise, it's not going to fit in the area that I want to put it. So it's pretty hard to cut a 16th of an inch off one end. So what I'm going to do, this represents this little area right here. Okay, so what I'm going to do is when I do my dado, I'll just make my dado in about, 16th of an inch in from the end, and then I'll sand off the end. That'll be a lot easier. And as you may have noticed, I have all kinds of sanders, so I shouldn't have any problem doing that. These two white boards are going to be the doors. I'll be gluing them together, and I'll be making two doors 24 inches square. And they'll go over top of the case, and they'll open up like this. Now I've got to make sure that I don't make the case too big, because I can always cut the doors down a bit, but I can't cut them up. You know, I've been thinking about what I said about the doors have to fit. I think what I better do is make the doors first. So, okay, if this board is 4 feet long, half is 2 feet. You know, I didn't realize until just recently that a narrow kerf 12-inch blade was available. And I've got this one from the Bosch people, and I'm finding that I'm using it a lot more than I actually do my more expensive CMT blade, because it has a nice narrow kerf and it cuts just as good. Normally I don't pull the saw through the wood like that, but because this saw has such an incredibly smooth action, I feel quite comfortable treating it like it was a radial arm saw. Another bonus is, I don't get as much sawdust thrown up into the air. It gets caught in that big hose that you see behind the saw there. And as long as you don't let the saw get going too fast, it's not going to climb on the wood and kick on you. Now I hope you can see this, but this is where you can really see that this board is actually made up of, in this case I think it's 8 separate boards. Here's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and a little one, 8. Well, there's a little bit of squeeze out there, but nothing that can't be easily removed. I've glued up the second door now, and I think it's probably time to close off the little cupboard part one. Hope you watch for part two. Oh, and by the way, this time I did remember to clean out that little brush, so I'll get to use it again.